Hello everyone, welcome to this tutorial on Introduction to GChempaint. In this tutorial, we will learn about GChempaint, install GChempaint on Windows OS, install GChempaint on Ubuntu OS 12.04. We will also learn menubar, toolbars and panel of GChempaint interface. Preferences window, draw structures using tools and save the drawing with .mol extension. To record this tutorial, I am using Ubuntu Linux OS version 12.04, Windows version 7, GChempaint version 3.3-1210, Firefox browser 31.0, Java version 7. To follow this tutorial, you must have internet connection, Synaptic Package Manager installed on your system, knowledge of terminal on Ubuntu, knowledge of command prompt on Windows. Please note, to run GChempaint, you should have Java installed on your system. Java can be installed on Ubuntu using Synaptic Package Manager. For example, open JDK-7-JRE. Let us learn about GChempaint. GChempaint is a 2D chemical structures editor and viewer. It is free and open source cross-platform application developed in Java. It allows to import and export structure data in plain text formats like smiles, mol file, CML and inchi keys. Let us start with GChempaint installation on Ubuntu 12.04 OS. Open Firefox web browser. In the address bar, type the URL http://gchempaint.github.io to install GChempaint on Ubuntu. You will be directed to the download page of GChempaint. On the web page, locate download a recent jar file from GitHub. Current is 3.3-1210. Click on the desktop application 6.8 MB. Save file dialog box opens. Click on Save File button. Let us move the saved file from Downloads folder to Desktop. Right click on the saved file and select Move to Desktop. To open new GChempaint window, we need Terminal. Press Ctrl, Alt and T keys simultaneously to open the terminal. Type CD space desktop and press enter. Type java space hyphen jar space /gchempaint-3.3-1210.jar and press enter. GChempaint window opens. Please note, GChempaint can be opened through the terminal only. Let us move on to Windows installation process. Let us install Java on Windows OS. Open Firefox web browser on your Windows machine. In the address bar, type GRE-7-downloads and press enter. A new web page opens. Click on the link Java SE Runtime Environment 7 Downloads-Oracle. Download page opens. On the web page, accept the license agreement. Select GRE-7-Windows-i586.exe link. Save file dialog box opens. Click on Save File button. The file will be downloaded in the Downloads folder. Click on the downloaded file. Follow the installation process to install Java. Click on Close. GRE-7 will be installed on your machine. Let us install GChempaint. Open Firefox web browser on your Windows machine. In the address bar, type the URL http://gchempaint.github.io to install GChempaint on Windows. You will be directed to the download page of GChempaint. On the web page, locate download a recent jar file from GitHub. Current is 3.3-1210. Click on the Desktop Application 6.8 MB. Save File dialog box opens. Click on Save File button. The .jar file will be downloaded to Downloads folder. Open Downloads folder and select the file jkempaint-3.3-1210.jar. You can download available latest version. Right-click on the executable file. Select Open to open jkempaint. Alternatively, you can open jkempaint using command prompt. To open command prompt, press Windows and R keys simultaneously on the keyboard. Run prompt box opens. In the open box, type CMD and click on OK. Command prompt opens. Let us go to the downloads folder where we have downloaded our .jar file. Type at the prompt CD space downloads and press enter. Type Java space hyphen jar space jkempaint hyphen 3.3-1210.jar and press enter. Jkempaint window opens. If an error appears on the command prompt, go to program files, locate the Java folder and click on it. Locate bin folder and right click on it. Navigate to properties. Copy the address c:\programfiles within brackets x86/java/jre7. To set the path, follow the steps. Right click on My Computer, select Properties option. Click on Advanced System Settings and then click on Environment Variables. In System Variables, search for Path. Click on Edit. Edit System Variable dialog box opens. Paste the address c:\programfiles within brackets x86/java/jre7. Click on OK and close the windows. Jkempaint window looks like this. This is the menu bar. Menu bar contains menu items like File, Edit, View, Atom, Bond, Tools, R groups, Templates, and Help. Toolbars contain all the tools required for you to work with Jkempaint. Jkempaint window has formatting tools on the top, bond tools on the left, ring tools on the right, and element tools at the bottom. Panel displays the drawn structures. Now to Jkempaint Preferences window. Click on Draw a Chain tool. Click and drag the chain to 6 carbon atoms on the panel. Notice that carbon chain does not contain any atoms. Go to Edit menu, navigate to Preferences and click on it. Preferences window opens. Preferences window has two tabs, Display Preferences and Other Preferences. By default, Display Preferences tab is selected. Notice that none of the checkboxes are selected here. Let us click on a few checkboxes and see how they are useful. To show methyl groups on the chain, click on Show Explicit Methyl Groups. To show hydrogens, click on Implicit Hydrogens. Click on Apply and OK buttons to apply the changes. As an example, let us draw phosphoric acid H3PO4. To draw, click on Phosphorus P tool and then click on the panel. Phosphine will be displayed. Click on Oxygen O tool and click on Single Bond tool. Place the cursor on P, a small blue colored circle appears on it. Click on P and drag to draw 4 hydroxy bonds. You will notice a red line below phosphorus atom. This indicates that valency is not complete. To complete the valency, let us make the top phosphorus hydroxy bond as a double bond. Click on Double Bond tool. Click on Top Phosphorus Hydroxy Bond. The obtained structure is phosphoric acid. Notice that all the atoms in the structure are black colored. To show Rasmol color of the element, go to Edit menu and navigate to Preferences. In the window, click on Color Atoms by Element checkbox. It shows Rasmol color of the element. Click on Apply and OK buttons to apply the changes. Note that elements appear with their Rasmol colors. Let us save the file. Click on File menu and select Save As. Save As dialog box opens. Select Desktop folder to save the file on desktop. Type the file name as phosphoric acid and click on Save button. The file will be saved with .mol extension. Let us summarize. In this tutorial, we have learnt about GChemPaint, install GChemPaint on Windows OS, install GChemPaint on Ubuntu OS 12.04, menu bar, toolbars and panel of GChemPaint interface, preferences window, draw structures using tools and save the drawing with .mol extension. As an assignment, install GChemPaint, explore various menu items. This video summarizes the spoken tutorial project. If you do not have good bandwidth, you can download and watch it. Spoken tutorial team gives certificates to those who pass an online test. For more details, please write to contact@spoken-tutorial.org. Spoken Tutorial Project is a part of the Talk to a Teacher project. It is supported by the National Mission on Education through ICT, MHRD, Government of India. More information on this mission is available at this link. This is Madhuri Ganpati from IIT Bombay signing off. Thank you for joining.